Hi, Alex here from redeveloper.com. Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this tutorial about UI stack views. Now I want you to hit that subscribe button because we are going to dive deep into UI stack views. We are going to have an advanced approach. So if you want to build out this interface, make sure to keep on watching. UI stack views, they are so awesome. So let's just jump right into our current Xcode project and go ahead and create any type of new project as a storyboard project, because yeah, we need to use storyboards, not Swift UI, to use UI stack views. And go ahead and click the link down below so you can grab my stack UI view plus extension and UI stack view expansion files, which we will use for this tutorial, so we can concentrate on UI stack views. Now we are going to go a little bit advanced on UI stack views, but yeah, if you are not familiar with any UI stack view stuff, you will be comfortable with this too. So I'm going to go with a universal approach, so you can use UI stack views anywhere in your code easily. So that's why I have created this UI view plus and UI stack view plus extensions, so we can make our lives a little bit easier. So first things first, when you drag and drop these free files here, you will see that we have a missing return in the function, and that is what we are going to build out today. But let's just focus on this extension on a UI view. All of our stack views will be on a UI view. So I just figured we want to add a VStack or an HStack on a UI view. And this VStack and HStack is basically a stack that is file private, so we don't mess around with it, as a vertical axis and a horizontal axis UI stack view. And here we have all of our properties. We have our views, spacing, alignment, distribution for our UI stack view. And as you can see, it returns a UI stack view in return here to the V stack, and the H stack returns a UI stack view. And it is discardable result because we might not want to use that. And you will see later on why we will not use that basically. And let's just go here and create our first UI stack view. So let stack view equals UI stack view, and let's add our arrange subviews, which we get from this views that we will add later on. So this is an array of views that will be on the stack view. And finally, we want to return our stack view because yeah, it expects us to return our stack view. Now let's just configure this stack view with the elements that we do add in here. First of all, axis. So that is pretty easy. Stack view axis equals axis that we are adding here. Stack view spacing again equals spacing. There we go. Stack view dot alignment equals alignment. Stack view distribution equals distribution. Now I won't go into detail, much detail into how all of these work. Basically, axis is vertical, horizontal, spacing, the spacing, the distance between the views that we add as arrange subviews, alignment, center, and so on. But fill is okay. Distribution, fill equally or fill. We are going to start off with fill equally because it's really easy to understand. Then we are going to move on to fill, but we will see that later on. So next up, because this is a UI view extension, we want to add this stack view as a subview of our VR view. So what we want to add is add subview and stack view. Next up, we want to constrain it, and here comes in the real interesting part on our UI view part. I'm just going to add it to some sort of view, and I believe we are, yeah, that's what we are going to use. So go ahead and take a look at it. It's basic auto layout. Okay, so stack view edge two. There we go, edge two, and we are going to use the second one and self, because we are in extension. Okay, and that takes care of this extension. So let's use it. As you can see, again, stack is a file private. We are going to use vstack and hstack. And that takes care of our helper files. Let's jump into our view controller. Okay, now, as you can see, I have already created some views just to save on time. We have a container and views ranging from 1 to 5 with different system color background colors. Okay, and this container is kind of different. We don't have a background color for it, but that will be basically, I will really need a container, not just the UI view controller's view, to have those constraints ready so we can work with hstack and a vstack. So first off, let's just add our container, and that is pretty simple. Let's just grab our view and dot add subview and container, and we want to put it on top, so all sides should be skimmed to the left and to the top of our container. So again, we're going to use container and edge. And as you can see here, we have an option to use safe area. So let's take a look at that. Edges to view, that's okay. And safe area. This is again from the extensions that I have created and sent to you. Okay, let's select all, because that is really interesting to see. We are selecting safe areas for all sides. And to see some stuff here, let's add a background color to our container. So background color equals, let's say, dot red, why not? Or rather, yet system red. So not blind ourselves here. And let's just build and run and see how that looks like. Okay, let's just wait for that, and we should see. There we go. We have our safe area layout guides real nice here. And if I rotate my device, you can see that even on the leading and trailing edges, we have these awesome safe areas covered. Okay, I will just remove this because we don't need it. And yeah, let's move forward. Let's add some finally, UI stack views to our container. And that is pretty simple. Just go container, and what do you want to add? Well, I want to add a vertical stack. So I just type in vstack. As you can see, there are some default values, but I will choose the one which is longer so we can iterate through. Now here we have a list of views. So I will just add in here view one, comma, view two. Spacing. Let's add spacing, maybe 8. Alignment, let's say fill is okay, but fill is basically the default, so I will just safely delete this. Distribution, for now, let's just show it as a fill equally. And basically that's it. We have a vstack. How awesome is that? You just declare those two views and just add it there. Really, really nice. Now, you can't see really the spacing. As you can see, we don't have any spacing here. So for that to be shown, because U2 also has a system red background color, let's just delete all of this. And we will see now the white 8 pixels or 8 points spacing there. Awesome. Now, let's move forward. And what I like to do here is just add these returns to be in new line and really visual of adding the view one and then view two. Okay, I want to, let's say, let me just talk about distribution. So if we just delete this distribution and build and run, you will see that view one will take up all its place, that, or rather at view two in our case, and it's kind of not what we want. So let's just add a height to our view one, and we do have a set height and set width and set frame if you wanted to. Extension in the downloaded resources, but I'm just going to use set height, and it returns a UI view. How convenient, because we do need UI views, just so you know. We are just grabbing the view and then returning it with a certain height. And let's use this as 300 maybe, and let's build and run. And because this is set to fill the VStack, now we have our white container, blue container, and our red container. Now that is really, really nice. Okay, let's move forward and add in here, why not, a horizontal stack. And all of the properties are the same. We want to add in here some views, and I will add all of the rest of the views: view 3, view 4, and view 5. Make sure that all of them are separated by a comma. And I will just add in these returns here. Yeah, I know it's an H stack, they are one by one, side by side, but I really like to see this laid out on a vertical space. Spacing, let's add in here again 8. Let's delete the alignment. Fill is perfectly fine for most cases. And distribution, let's have them as fill equally just for now. And let's hit Command R and see what we got. And how awesome is that? So it's really with a few lines of code you have created in this layout. So let's move forward. Let's see, what if I don't want to have a height, a specific height for our view 1, but I want to have it for our horizontal stack? That is okay. Now we don't use set height because that will return UI view. We want to return here UI stack view. So just go on and add height. As you can see, it returns, or you can't really see, it's under me, it returns a UI stack view. And we want to have this as 300. And while we are at it, let's remove this fill equally distribution and let's add in here, let's see, our height, set height, let's see here, let this be 100, and view 4 should be 250. Okay, and maybe I will need to tab this out and have a spacing there. Okay, that looks really nice. Let's build and run and see how all of this looks like. Okay, as I expected, we have this 300 height, we have 100 width, 250, and the rest. Now let's just hit Command and arrow, and we can change the orientation. Looks really, really nice. Okay, what is up next? Well, we might want to add some background. So as you already saw, this height modifier, so-called modifier, is returning a UI stack view too. So there are quite a lot here in the extensions that I added, and one of them is setup subviews, with which you can set the background color of our UI stack view. And if you haven't already known, it is a pain to add background color to our stack views. So let's add in here, let's say gray, or let's say, do we have some system gray? There we go, system gray, corner radius. Let's add in here 5, and I won't bother with border width or border color. You just go ahead and experiment with it. And while we are at it, let's use the returns here to see this awesome dot notation. And how awesome is that? It looks really structured, and how you would understand by just looking at it. Okay, there we have our gray background because of the 5 pixel spacing. And yeah, we don't kind of see the corner radius, and that is because those views are on top of our UI stack view. So what we need to do here is basically add some padding to it. So let's do that. Let's add a dot padding, and again it returns a UI stack view. And for the margins, we could add in here more. It's basically an array of margins, but I will just go for all margins for now. And the amount for the margins, let's say 12 maybe. Okay, so let me just hit return before the padding, so it looks really nice. Hit Command R and the build has succeeded and it looks really, really nice. As you can see, we can also see here the padding. I don't know if the corner radius because of the padding, I don't know if that is seeable. And down here, because we are not adhering to the layout, safe area layout guides, we cannot really see it. But let's just hit command and the arrow, and yeah, it looks really nice. Let me just adhere to the safe area layout guides. So I will add the container to our view with our safe area. You already know this, or you could choose horizontal and so on. Go ahead and play around with that. Okay, let's just build and run. And there we go. We can already see those 5 pixel corners at the bottom. And we do have the layout stretched only to the safe area layout guide. So how awesome is that? With a few lines of code, you can see it's super simple, really intuitive. You can lay out your views with UI stack views, and of course with these kind of helpers that are just kind of extensions that really will make your life easier. So now you know how you can build out your views with the help of UI stack view quite easily. We have taken a deep dive approach, and now you can build out any type of view. I want you to hit that notification bell, because in my next video we are going to talk about how to install a CocoaPod. That's right. And in the meantime, I want you to take a look at these two videos as well. I talk a lot about Swift UI iOS development. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.